And now to Sunday specials. Rice farmers in Nguru and Karasu Waluku government areas of Yobe State have accused suspected herders of terrorizing them in their communities. They lament that the cows of the herders have been plundering their rice farmlands without remorse. In this report, TVC News' Michael Oshoma took a 270-kilometer drive to a village to ascertain the true nature of events.
This is a large Daba Giwa community bordering the town of Nguru in Yobe State, a village reputed for large-scale of rice farming and other crafts. The farmers in this community have over time had issues with herdsmen due to the act of open grazing. TVC News took a drive to the community to speak with some farmers on the crisis. I met Kalisu, a young farmer who recently ventured into cultivating 30 acres of rice. He says he spent a lot of money channeling water from the riverbank and digging boreholes for the Fulani settlers residing close to him. The provision he made for the herdsmen was to stop them from grazing in his farm, but his efforts were in vain.
There is a specification that they have to consider where I provide for them. I say, okay, use this place. At any time if you're coming, pass this place. Go for your grazing. When you're coming, this is a place I provide for you. Go and drink water. I pay for them. I pay for it, for the label. But up to now, they have caused a damage for me. Serious damage.
In a series of meetings, the village head and the resident of the community had admonished the herdsmen in question to live in peace with farmers, but to no avail.
We have admonished the herders to always live in peace with farmers and stop grazing their farm, but they wouldn't listen.
We need peace in this country, but we need justice. We should not call for peace, but we should work for justice so that at least we should be able to have a peace in this country. We can't stop them. That's why they have been inherited. And actually us, we are the farmers and they are the headsmen, so we can't stop them.
Another farmer, Mohammed, says if not for the intervention of the traditional ruler, the clashes between the herdsmen and the farmers would have been bloody.
Especially the emir and the district head and the village head in this emirate, they call on our people to live in harmony. Don't take action. Don't take this in your hand. Anything happen, take it to... But the planning, they are not this thing. Always, that is our problem.
Kalisu notes that the Go Back to Farm program initiated by the government is not hitting results due to the relentless open grazing by herders, which, if not tackled, it may lead to a shortage of food in the country. I want to
see that. We are farming purposely for us to be able to key into the federal government what they are saying about this issue of agriculture, that we should go back to farm. So we are really supporting this government, and we are part of the government. So we have to do this, even for the food security. That is why we are engaging in farming. But look at the result.
To Miati Allah and Kautal Hore, to call on these herdsmen to stop doing what they are doing to the farmers. We will not stop them to go to rearing, but they will not stop us to go to our farm.
We tried to get the Miati Anla Kautu spokesman to react to the allegation, but he was unable to be reached. Farmers of Daba Large Giwa community in Nguru local government area of Yobe State say farmer and herdsmen crisis has lingered for the past 10 years. They call on relevant authorities to intervene before it gets out of hand. Michael Oshoma, TVC News, Nguru, Yobe State.